Hey, what's up guys, it's Jess. Welcome back to my channel. It's that time of year where admission letters are rolling in and you're gonna have to decide which college you want to commit to. In my college decision process, I was stuck between a couple schools and I wasn't sure which one to go to, and I definitely turned to YouTube to kind of hear what people's experiences were at these different universities. Since I'm a student there, I'm making this video to offer some insight as to what the school is like, and today's video is gonna be why you shouldn't go to UW. As a disclaimer, obviously I'm a UW student, so I had to have thought that the pros outweighed the cons, and I still do. I genuinely really, really love the school, so if you guys want me to make a separate video explaining why you should go to UW, then I'll be sure to post that as well. I'm just gonna go ahead and get started into this list. The overarching theme of this list is that UW's slogan is not 100% accurate. UW's slogan is be boundless, and to be honest, there are a lot of boundaries in place that prevent students from succeeding at the UW. The first one is the admissions process to majors. Pretty much everyone sees college as the opportunity to advance your education in subjects you're actually interested in. This means, you know, concentrating in a major and taking classes that you actually really love in hopes of graduating with a degree and pursuing a career that you really, really like. You know, it's not like middle school or high school where you have to take the same classes as everyone else. College is really for you and for what you want to do in the future. However, if you attend the University of Washington, there is a very real chance that you might not have the opportunity to do that. I didn't even know this was a thing before applying to colleges, but you're not guaranteed to study what you actually want to study. Some colleges might be like, okay, you want to study this? Good for you. Go ahead. UW's not like this.
Flipping forgot to press record on the audio for my flipping microphone, so I don't feel like recording that whole intro again, but hopefully the audio is better at this point in the video. Okay, so back to applying for your majors. With some majors at the UW, you are able to be directly admitted, but this is not the case for every single major, nor do I think it's fair to every single person. What I have noticed is that a large portion of people that get directly admitted into their majors are from Washington. This is gonna sound a little harsh, but it's honest. I have seen numerous questionable people get directly accepted into the computer science major because they are a Washington state resident. And I've seen these people get accepted over out-of-state people who are more qualified and honestly more passionate about computer science. So as an out-of-state student, I see the ways in which University of Washington prioritizes its in-state students. And I get it, it's a public university, but it's very, very noticeable in a lot of different ways. So I'm just putting that out there. If you're an out-of-state student, that's one thing you have to worry about. Not to say that in-state people don't struggle too, because these majors are still hard to get into.
Okay, so to clarify things more, regardless if you're an in-state or out-of-state student, it is significantly harder to get into your major through regular applying versus being directly admitted. So if you have the chance to directly apply to your major, definitely do it and take that opportunity seriously, because I know so many people who didn't do this and they regret it.
So if you're not able to be directly admitted into your major, you have to apply to your major, and this can be such a stressful process. I got into both my majors on the first try, but this is not the case with everyone, and this is definitely not what you should expect, especially if you are trying to pursue a STEM field, specifically like computer science or engineering. University of Washington has some of the best programs for STEM in the United States, but they're really hard to get into, so. I know people that are really, really passionate about what they want to do, and they didn't get into their major the first time. Or the second time. So I was talking about this earlier, but college is supposed to be that time where you're studying something you actually love. And if you can't get into your major, you can't study what you actually love. If you're stuck at the university, basically like staying till the 4 years, and you're not able to get into the major of your choice, you have to pick a different major. And this could be something that you don't even like. I have seen this happen with multiple people who have lost their love for the University of Washington and lost their love for college because they're stuck in a major that they don't truly love. Honestly, this con specifically is something you should really, really consider before you commit to the University of Washington. Some majors are more difficult to get into than others, and based on what I've seen as a student, I think the hardest majors to get into are definitely computer science and engineering. Another random one that's hard to get into is architecture. I can only speak on my experience with astronomy and physics in terms of what it's like to actually apply to the major. Pretty much what I was judged on was my grades and then my personal statement. I know people who didn't get accepted into their majors based on one grade in one course. I guess this is kind of a segue into the next con, and it's that you need to take prerequisite classes in order to apply to the major. Especially if you're applying to a STEM major, these prerequisite courses are designed to weed people out. I'm not even kidding. It's this weird environment where it feels super competitive because everyone in that class is trying to get into the major that you want to get into. And there's limited spots, so everyone's kind of like for themselves. Not only is the workload super hard, but the exams are extremely difficult. As someone who's used to getting an average grade of an A on pretty much all of my exams, getting a 50% on a midterm doesn't sound too good. That is literally the reality with some of these courses, is that the midterm averages will be 50%. There will be that one kid that gets a 98%, and I'm like, how on earth do you do that? How do you do that? It will be one person. One person in your class will get that. No one else. If it's any consolation, mostly everyone is in the same boat as you, but it's still like really mentally frustrating when you get back a grade and it's not what you expect it to be. In my case, I've adjusted to it, so I expect the worst now. So that's just something to keep in mind. You're gonna have to take prereqs. They're gonna be difficult. It's gonna be super competitive. And honestly, you kind of need to do really well in these courses because they can make a difference on your admissions to the majors. I know it sounds like UW sucks right now, but I promise I could actually justify all of these cons in a separate video. So don't worry, like there is an upside, but I'm gonna go ahead and keep listing the cons. Next con I will talk about is related to professors at the UW. I don't know why I expected my professors at the university level to be better than my high school teachers. I just had this thought process where the higher level education, the better the teachers are. But I was wrong. I was very wrong. Not to say that all the professors are bad. I've had some pretty okay professors. I will say that out of the four math classes I've taken at the UW, I've had one good math teacher. As I mentioned in a previous video, I think one of the things that helped me succeed so much in high school was having these connections with the teachers, and it's really hard to do that in college. Most professors won't know you exist, I gotta be honest. There's multiple cons within this one con. I've noticed some of my professors at UW are pretty unapproachable, and I'm a very extroverted, confident person, and if I think they're unapproachable, they're probably unapproachable. I remember my first math class at UW. It was a prereq for my major. I went to this dude's office hours, first week of class. No one was there. Now I know why. I went to his office hours to get help with a homework problem I was struggling with, and he basically kicked me out. Like, I get it, he's a professor, but in his responses to me, he just had a very, I'm better than you attitude. When I sat down to work on the problem, he basically said, get out of my office, work on the problem, and maybe come back when you have more specific questions. Like, bruh, I was flipping struggling in your class. Maybe if you were a better teacher, I would understand how to do the homework. After that incident, I never went to a single of his office hours. For my second math class, I had this professor who I couldn't really understand, and he was shouting all of the time. So I never showed up after the first day. The third professor was a really good math professor, and so I'm just gonna say this here. If you happen to take a math course at UW, Professor Lovelace is so good. And then I went back to having not so good of a math teacher for my next class. Anyway, the overall point I'm trying to make here is that some of these teachers aren't gonna be the best. Some of them might be good, but might not be suited for the way you learn. Just because you are really, 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 really smart does not make you a good teacher. I think that's something the university doesn't quite understand yet. The next con is cost of tuition. As an in-state student, it's not that bad, but as an out-of-state student, you are literally going to be drowning in debt. The University of Washington was my cheapest option, and it was still over $54,000 a year. I even have a scholarship, and I'm struggling to pay for college. Honestly, cost was a really big factor for me when choosing my colleges. I remember when I was a senior, and I was super excited to get into UCSD, and I couldn't go because it was $66,000, and there was no way my family and I were going to be able to afford that. That's one of the things I think sucks about college in general, is that it's so expensive and it often turns people away from going to the college of their dreams. So while UW isn't the most expensive for an out-of-state student, it is still really, really expensive. Kind of going off of that, there is little you can do to reduce your tuition from my experience. I went to the residency office the first week of school and I had an appointment, and they basically listed all of the reasons why it was impossible for me to get in-state tuition. There's one requirement where they expect you to work like a 40-hour work week and be a full-time student. How the heck am I supposed to do that? So that's why they have these really difficult requirements, because they don't want to see out-of-state people getting in-state tuition. I understand why these requirements requirements are in place, because honestly, if I were an in-state student and chose Washington because of the cost, I wouldn't want out-of-state students to have to pay the same cost. But honestly, if cost of tuition was low enough, I wouldn't care if out-of-state students paid the same amount. Like, I don't want anyone to go in debt. Are you kidding me? Anyway, the next con is class scheduling. If you're watching this video, you're probably going to be a freshman soon at UW. And I'm just letting you know that you're totally screwed over for your class scheduling. As a freshman, you get like the lowest priority in terms of choosing your classes. There's a chance you might not even get into the classes you need to take, and that can totally screw over your schedule. Like I said, you need to take a lot of prerequisite classes to get into your major, but if you can't even get into the prerequisite class, you're kind of screwed over as to when you can apply for your major. Not only that, but if you're lucky enough to get into a class, there's very little room to decide what time the class is or who the professor is. Most of the time, you're gonna be stuck with a class that no one wants, like 8:30 in the morning or 6 p.m. at night with a professor that sucks. There's a lot of ways you can work around this, and I'll talk about that in future videos, but I'm just saying that that's kind of something to consider. The next con is safety, or the lack of safety. The University of Washington is located in Seattle, but it's also located next to what's called the Ave. The Ave is not somewhere you want to be at night. I can't tell you how many times I've gotten UW alerts on my phone where there's a robbery two blocks down from me and the suspect hasn't been found. One time it was this guy running around with an axe. One time there was a guy that got into my residence hall and literally followed a girl to her room. And I think she like got choked or something, but she was fine afterwards and the suspect got away. A lot of these times, the suspect always gets away. So that's just another thing to consider. UW is not in the safest place, but honestly, what college is? Either your college is in the middle of nowhere, or it's in a really dangerous city and there's like no in between. Honestly, I feel pretty safe at UW, but like right next to UW, I don't feel the safest. Next thing isn't really a con for me, but it might be a con for other people, and that's that UW doesn't really have an active like party scene. I personally don't go to parties. I don't drink, I don't smoke. That's not my type of vibe at all, but if you are someone that does like those type of social gatherings, I would say that they're not very popular at our school. I would say that's definitely more active within the Greek community, and there are ways you can be involved even if you're not in a sorority or fraternity. I'd say that it's not like super active, and if you really want to go to a party, you kind of have to like seek out one, or you have to like know people who know people that are running the party, stuff like that. The next con is what's called the Seattle Freeze. As a non-Seattle resident, I would say that this is pretty accurate. The Seattle Freeze basically states that everyone in Seattle kind of keeps to themselves and they're very antisocial and there's not much room to kind of talk with new people. I am a very confident, extroverted type of person that loves to talk to new people. And if I think it's hard to make friends, it's hard to make friends. I will say that there's a lot of opportunities to meet new people, but it's definitely hard to make solid friendships. I will say that the friends that I did make hold a very special place in my heart, aka the girls from the boxing team. I love you guys. Can't wait to see you soon. The next con is the weather, and this is probably the most common con you'll hear about the University of Washington. I am someone who really loves rain, but it's not like the thunderstorm type of rain. It's kind of like the gross, mucky type of rain. It's also not super fun to be wearing a cute outfit, walking 10 minutes to your quiz section in the rain, and having to sit next to that really cute lab partner in your physics 123 class while you're soaking wet. I am someone who thinks that shoes can make or break an outfit, so I love wearing Jordans, I love wearing slides when I'm trying to be comfortable, and both of those don't really work out well when it's pouring rain. The next con definitely applies to UW, but I think this applies to like almost every single college. This is kind of TMI and no one really talks about it, but I thought I'd mention it just in case. That hookup culture is a very real thing. And maybe you might be into that, like no judging whatsoever, but I'm someone who's definitely not into that. Like, bro, why can't you like me because I have a 4.0 in my physics class, not because I'm hot. Anyway, I won't go into too much detail with that, but I will say it is a thing at UW, and it probably is a thing at almost every other college in the United States. This is another random one, but don't go to the University of Washington if you're anywhere between moderate and really conservative, because the UW community will literally hate your guts. The UW community is really, we love everyone unless you're Republican. That's kind of all I have to say on the matter. I personally don't have a problem with it, but it's just something to consider. The University of Washington is a really big campus, so another inevitable con is that you're gonna have to do a lot of walking. This might not seem like a problem to you until you have class on one side of campus, your professor keeps you a couple minutes late, so now you have less than 10 minutes to make it to your class on the complete opposite side of campus. Another con is that large lectures are kind of inevitable. You're gonna have to take at least one. I personally don't mind them, and I'm the type of student that likes to sit in the front of the lecture hall. Like I mentioned, I sit in the front, but I think that's because if I sat anywhere else, I would be way too distracted or like super tired and fall asleep. If you sit in the back, you will literally see people in front of you that are like online shopping on their computer, or, you know, on their phone, whatever. It's just a really distracting environment seeing like all of these students that might not even be paying attention to the lecture. It's also easier to hear the professor if you sit closer to the front. Again, these are all tips I can mention in another like separate video, but I will say that, you know, large lectures are definitely something you're gonna see at the UW. Another random one is that it's a little selective to get an on-campus job at the UW. I don't know if this is just a campus tour guide position or what, but it was really selective to get that job. I made it up to the last round and then they didn't accept me, so. The next con kind of talks about the type of person that should go to the UW. If you are not motivated, dedicated, on top of your work, know what you wanna do, you're not gonna succeed at the UW. There is just so little room to slack off at a university like this. I know college can be a place of discovery for some people, you know, kind of figuring out what they wanna do. I wouldn't say UW necessarily fosters that type of environment. I know people who had ideas on what they wanted to do, but weren't really set on a major, and they literally withdrew from the university because of how stressful it was. Another thing is that there will always be someone that's better than you. Like how I mentioned in my physics class, where the class average was like a 50% and that one kid got like a 98%. Honestly, I don't let this affect me at all. If anything, I think it's more motivating to have people that, you know, might be better at you in a certain class or whatever. But I know for some people that might not be the environment that they like, and that's okay. I will say that it's kind of hard to make progress if you're used to being the best all the time, though. So that's the end of my list on reasons why you shouldn't go to the University of Washington. But like I mentioned earlier, I'm a UW Husky. I love the school. I really think that the pros outweigh the cons. So if you guys want me to post a separate video explaining why you should go to the University of Washington, then I'll be happy to post that. If you guys are somewhere in your college decision-making process, I wish you the best of luck, and I hope you all end up committing to a college that's best for you. Be sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video.